What's up, everybody? I hope everybody's still doing well and staying safe and healthy out there. Today, I want to work on this recording. This is Wayne Shorter's Speak No Evil, and I just want to go through the melody to show an easy fingering for the melody. The bridge is a little tricky for some, but I also have incorporated a way to play kind of like the chords along with the melody, because particularly for songs like these that have like horn, I guess, harmony parts, to translate them to guitar can sometimes be not necessarily challenging as much as just it doesn't sound as full when you play some of the lines, the horn lines, without having the other harmony. So it's almost imperative that you figure out a way to at least play a two-part harmony, if not more. So in that instance, I, especially if you're playing in a situation where you don't have another voice to kind of carry the other note, melody notes. So we're gonna go through a little short arrangement that I created for Speak No Evil, and just the melody, and then I'll explain it later in the latter part of the video. All right. So here we go. Of course, at the beginning, you're gonna play single note because the melody is in unison. So we got, then we chord, and right here, you can literally in the middle of this, and you'll notice that Herbie is playing all kind of stuff throughout this, because after he plays the melody, it's just sitting there. So you have all this free range to play in that empty space to keep it interesting. And what I'm doing, what I would encourage you to also do is, instead of just playing on the sitting on that one chord, that, like, for instance, this C minor 11 or C minor, whatever, just bump off of it, make it move. So if a horn player is, or a singer for that instance is saying ba-da, ba-da, you're giving, or you even yourself. Lot more interesting than just playing. That to me that's terrible. So you want to keep it interesting and keep it moving. C minor, do you have D flat major 7 flat 5? If you want to play lines in between that, you can play off of, on this major 7 flat 5, you of course can play, C minor pentatonic over that, you can play A flat major 7 over that, resolves back. But anyway, let's focus on the melody for right now. You can do just really quick also. You could play B flat melodic minor, which is really hip. You can play B flat melodic minor over that, and then resolve it to back to C minor. Gives it more of that sound if you want to use the B flat melodic minor, but it's at your discretion and it's up to your ears to explore. The primary thing is making sure that the melody is strong, and let's get back onto that. Sorry, once my ears start hearing things, I want to figure out, okay, what could we do? But we'll do save that for another video. So right now we have. Play E flat minor 11 and use the same chord, we're just moving it up. So we're using the same chord right here, just taking our finger off right there. So flat 7, flat 5. So we have E flat to E, pinky off, so we can get that melody note. Same thing with here, we're gonna go down here, use the same chord, we're just lifting our pinky. Pinky down again. Then we're playing the A flat 7, flat 5 to B flat minor 7, and here you can also play B flat melodic minor. Because right there you have this B flat melodic minor works perfectly over that section, because you have every single note. You have the flat 5 when with the sharp 7, the major 7, the major 7 here with the. And if you listen to Herbie, you can, he's in all the cats, they're alluding to that melodic minor. Melodic minor is an incredible scale, so make sure you learn that from top to bottom in all 12 keys. So we just repeat the same thing that we went through before. Now, let's get to the B section when it goes to the A half diminished to, so you got to walk that A to A flat, or G minor 7, G flat 7, or they're using a G flat 7 sharp 5, I'm sorry, sharp 11 or flat 5, F minor 7, like it's like a 2-5 B flat 7. Then you're gonna play this chord, which I like to call the Herbie Hancock chord, but it's just, I hear it a lot in my head for whatever reason, from Dolphin Dance and songs like that. It's just an altered, it's just a major 7 flat 5 chord, but I just like this particular voicing of it, where you have the E flat, the G, the major 7 or the D, the sharp 9, and then the sharp 5, sharp 11, sorry, flat 5. E flat, G, D, F sharp, and an A. Pretty chord, really pretty, really kind of like haunting chord sound. So let's go through this part right here. We have, And I found this to be the easiest fingering to get to the melody. So you're gonna have to move your fingers up. It's a little tricky. We have E flat, C, and the anchoring note right here is gonna be the C. Move. Move again. Move again. Then you're gonna play this, which is a variation of that, but the like shout at the end is, and then it falls. So one more time in time, one, two, ready, go. Move. 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 One more time, so we got, I'll play slow. That y'all can see this. Let me slide up a little bit. So we have E flat, I'm using this finger, move, so right here I have to, after the hitting this with this pinky, you got to move. Right there to this, and don't get frustrated. This is the trickiest part of the song, and particularly for guitarists, because we have to make the movement, we have to adjust. So once you get that, then it's back to the top. So hip. Then you're in it. This is, to me, I think this is a hip alternative to just playing a regular C minor blues. But C minor blueses are hip too, but this is, it's got that minor bluesish sound, but it has like a nice little bridge to it as well. So hopefully that makes a little sense, and you can use this when you're playing out, or just, you know, add it to your repertoire of songs. I wanna keep pushing these melody shorter films, so that we can just work on learning some songs, especially, you know, as the light at the end of the tunnel gets brighter and brighter for, quarantine and COVID. Hopefully we'll be able to get out more and play more. So you wanna just spend this time learning songs as much as possible, and learning hip ways to play it, especially if you don't have a full band, or if you're just playing as a duo or trio. You want to just, have some options. So hopefully that helps. Shoot me an email. Let me know what you think, and I'll talk to you soon.